This is about voting education, voter awareness, right? We're gonna talk, we're just gonna touch on that. Then we're gonna get into what I think is really effective, because I've been thinking about y'all for at least a week now. That's real talk. Thinking about that one individual who I know I'm gonna touch for about a week now. See, y'all have speakers that come into these schools, and you know, as a speaker, you know, we get our itinerary and we know what we're supposed to do. But so many people in this arena, they don't really care about what they're coming in to say or who they're coming in here to talk to. I'm not like that. Young Blood, I asked the administrator, I said, turn them around. Now, because I was going to ask you to do that when I got up here anyway. I'm just so real with you, right? So let's touch on the voter registration real quick. If you're 17, you do need to get registered to vote, because it allows you to play this political game that exists here in America, okay? So now that we've got that out of the way, let me hold this up. Matter of fact, I'll pass it around. Start right here. Pass it around. I'm cut from a different cloth, all right? I worked with Reverend Dr. Joseph Lowry, Reverend Sharp, and actually founded National Action Network, which is a civil rights organization here. But I've since developed my own organization called Save OurSelves. Save OurSelves is very important to me, because I'm here to kick it to you on what's going to happen to you if you continue down the path that some of y'all are on. Now, it's real. I go to all kinds of schools. Morehouse, Spelman, Kennesaw State, just spoke at Towers High School not too long ago. Do me the proper respect and pass that around. All of these prestigious schools that I go to and prestigious people that I speak before, I actually like doing this more. I like doing this more because y'all already have been tested, right? Y'all are in this alternative school for a reason. Before I came in today, they said, Brother Coleman, you know, you gotta go speak to them at-risk students. I don't even like that term, at-risk students. Young Blood, I appreciate you doing that, but man, please don't toss that card like that no more, man, because that card got a lot of pain, heartache, straight up. That card right there, that card right there is what's waiting on some of y'all. I'm just telling you, look to your left and look to your right. Statistically, what we got? Is it mandatory or whatnot?
You just said.
Said, okay. Well, listen, let me tell you this. Keep passing that thing around. Statistically, when I say that card is what's waiting on some of y'all, y'all who hadn't seen it yet, that's my prison card. That's my inmate card. There ain't nothing to play with. There ain't nothing to laugh about. There ain't nothing to get up and talk about, man, please. That card right there disconnected me from my family for 3 years. That card right there, I spent 13 months in solitary confinement. See, this ain't some bougie Negro in here talking to y'all today. That card is real. But throughout all of that experience, I'm right here dedicating my time, giving it to the youth. 5 years as a head football coach of the youth. Got a son that's age 21, another one that's age 9. Mentor folks like Jabir. All I do is try to uplift y'all. Trayvon Martin, Jordan Davis, Kendrick Johnson. These aren't names that I'm just spitting out in the public. These are families that I work with. So it's a matter of respect that I got to have. When I said don't talk to that young fella, I know you didn't mean no disrespect by that. I know you didn't. I'm just trying to let you know the pain and the heartache that come with that. Now, when I say it's waiting on y'all, I wouldn't have named all those things that I've done or things that I'm doing if I really wanted that for y'all. I served 3 years in the federal penitentiary for a crime that I did not commit. That's real talk. 13 of those months was in an 8x9 cell, locked down 23 hours a day. Being fed through a slot in that door 23 hours a day, let me keep it real. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, I got 1 hour of rec. And that 1 hour of rec was probably in a room that you could cut off right here. And it was gated like that basketball court y'all got out front. This place looks like an institution. I'm gonna keep it real. They're already trying to program you and train your minds, young fellas and young sisters. So statistically speaking, what made young blood get up? One out of every three will be in prison. That's a documented fact. Now, can we break that? Hell yeah. Can we change that? Hell yeah. But right now, statistically, you can look to your left and to your right. And if you got your head down, it might be you. Statistically. See, when you got a cat that's in here, there's so many other things I could be doing on Friday afternoon. I'm a father, I told you that, two boys. I'm a husband, my mother. I've never even seen a picture of my biological father. Don't even know what he looks like, let alone know him. My mother had me when she was 15 years of age. Right now, so that makes her young. I'm 41. I ain't got no problem putting all my business out there. 41, so I got a young mama. But my young mama suffers from lupus, rheumatoid arthritis, and is legally blind. Why am I telling y'all this? See, coming in here talking to y'all is therapeutic for me. I told you all week I've been thinking about y'all, and that's real. There's somebody in this room that once I finish this delivery, will remember what I said. When I say that prison's waiting on you, if young blood, you couldn't handle that, you got up, that's good. Because I promise you this, you don't want to be cuffed, chained, and shackled and ushered through the prison system like cattle or slaves. I done that. That ain't for y'all. It ain't for me. It wasn't for me. That's why I take every ounce of pain and heartache that I went through and I try to deliver it to save one of y'all from going down that road.